Kia ora katoa katoa. Welcome to the historic St. John the Baptist Church here in Parnell, Auckland. A special welcome to those of you who are joining us via Shine TV or online. Today we celebrate the 14th Sunday in Ordinary Time, and our gospel reading from Mark chapter 6 challenges us to have faith to recognize God among us. The presider at this Mass is Father Stephen Berecz. Let us now stand and sing together the entrance hymn, Praise My Soul, the King of Heaven.
Praise my soul, the King of Heaven. Tribute bring, ransomed, healed, restored, forgiven, who like me his praise should sing. Praise him, praise him, praise him, praise him, praise the everlasting King. Praise him for his grace and
of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Greetings to you all, and especially those on Shine TV as we celebrate this Mass on Sunday. We give a warm welcome to those who are visitors with us and gather around the table of the Word and of Sacrament on this day. We also are aware of those who may be online and will later on come and view this Mass with us. We pray for you, and our intentions are for you this day to be at one with this community in Parnell. Placing ourselves before the Lord, we call on his mercy in our lives.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God,
King, O God, Almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who in the abasement of your Son have raised up a fallen world, fill your faithful with holy joy. For on those you have rescued from slavery to sin, you bestow eternal gladness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God for ever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. The heavens were opened, and I saw visions of God. When I saw this, I fell on my face, and I heard the voice of someone speaking. When the voice spoke to me, a spirit entered into me and set me on my feet, and I heard one speaking to me. Mortal, I am sending you to the people of Israel, to a nation of rebels who have rebelled against me. The descendants are impudent and stubborn. I am sending you to them, and you shall say to them, thus says the Lord God. Whether they hear or refuse to hear, for they are a rebellious house, they shall know that there has been a prophet among them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please. This was the reading from the second letter of Paul to the Corinthians. Considering the exceptional character of the revelations, to keep me from being too elated, a thorn was given me in the flesh, a messenger of Satan to torment me, to keep me from being too elated. 3 times I appealed to the Lord about this, that it would leave me. But he said to me, "My grace is sufficient for you, for power is made perfect in weakness. So I will boast all the more gladly of my weaknesses, so that the power of Christ may dwell in me. Therefore, I am content with weaknesses, insults, hardships, persecutions, and calamities for the sake of Christ. For whenever I am weak, then I am strong." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Spirit of the Lord is now upon me. He has sent me to bring good news to the poor. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus came to his hometown, and his disciples followed him. On the Sabbath, he began to teach in the synagogue, and many who heard him were astounded. They said, "Where did this man get all this? What is this wisdom that has been given to him? What deeds of power are being done by his hands? Is not this the carpenter, the son of Mary, and brother of James, and Joseph, and Judas, and Simon? And are not his sisters here with us?" And they took offense at him. Then Jesus said to them, "Prophets are not without honor except in their own hometown and among their own kin and in their own house." And Jesus could do no deed of power there, except that he laid his hands on a few sick people and cured them. And Jesus was amazed at their unbelief. Then he went about among the villages teaching. The Gospel of the Lord. It just goes to show that even Jesus can have a bad day. He goes to the synagogue, and those that he expects that would support him suddenly turn around and don't. And they know him too well. You know, it's that idea of familiarity breeds contempt, so to speak. And in terms of the routine of life, I suppose he was just part of the cog in the wheel of life, and that they knew him too well. And so it is that they couldn't understand his message. And for him, he suddenly realized that sometimes you need to have that ability to break away from that routine, break away from that familiarity. For myself, I often am driving along West Tamaki Drive, Tamaki Drive, and I'm racing to get to school. And of course, I'm neglecting the fact that there's a beautiful scenery of the harbour as I'm driving along. I do assure you that I am keeping my eye on the road. But, you know, as you're going from one point to another, you can often miss a lot of things that are going on. And it is so with ourselves in the church. We can go to our pew, walking past the people we know, and not recognise them, or not stopping to say hello, or how are you going? Just that simple question. Those are the kind of things that we forget to do because we get caught up in the routine of our own lives. And so the challenge really is to break out of that. Say, hi, how are you? And is there an opportunity that we could perhaps go down and have a coffee sometime? I often find about it at home too, where I should have been picking up the phone and speaking to a family member, but haven't got the time. I need to make the time. The neighbour next door, just to say hello, how are you? The opportunity to go and visit somebody who is shut in, or somebody who may be in a home that needs a visit. It's sometimes a task that we have to break out of our own ordinary time to allow God's grace to go about its business in the most amazing things, in the ordinariness of our lives. The second reading is very special to me because I took that motto, "My grace is enough for you, my power is best in weakness." We accept in humility that God has graced us with life that isn't perfect. But within that, God understands. And when I am weak, I am strong, he says to us, St. Paul. And so it is for ourselves that in the little things that we do, who we do regularly or perhaps and sometimes in our routine, we break out of, we can be a powerful influence of God's grace because God's grace is enough for us and it does most amazing things. We're not in control of it, but it is God's control, God's love, and it abounds in the community if we but break out of the routine or familiarity and extend God's love to others. It's pretty simple, but often very difficult to do. Invite you to stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Having listened to the word of God and having professed our faith, we put that faith into practice by asking our Father for the various helps we need to live out a Christian life.
For the Church of God, that all believers may be able to see the finger of God working in their lives, and accept the lines that He is tracing out for them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the leaders of God's people, that they may be given wisdom to teach His people and the courage to lead them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the nations of the world, that all may be wholehearted and honest in their search for peace and true human development. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and poor, that we Christians may see in them the presence of Jesus' suffering and respond in a way that helps and preserves their dignity. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our young people, that they may grow up strong in the faith and learn to appreciate true values for living. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, that they may be brought to enjoy the light of God's face in heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We take a moment for our own intentions. God of the prophets, in every age you send the word of truth, familiar yet new, a sign of contradiction. Let us not be counted among those who lack faith, but give us the vision to see Christ in our midst and to welcome your saving word. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Pray, friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. May this oblation dedicated to your name purify us, O Lord, and day by day bring our conduct closer to the life of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with the angels, archangels, with the thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glories without end, we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed
comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Stephen, our Bishop, and all your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, St. John the Baptist, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen.
Gathered round the table of the Lord, we pray the prayer Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who will live and reign for ever and ever. Amen. And the peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, Take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away
the body of Christ,
sins of the world,
the body of Christ.
Grant us peace.
Lord Jesus Christ, you made the Lord of mercy. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that having been replenished by such great gifts, we may gain the prize of salvation and never cease to praise you. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Just a word of thanks to those involved in preparing for this Mass and the ministries today, and we extend a warm invitation to anyone who may come to St. John the Baptist in Parnell to enjoy the lovely environment that we have in the Holy Land here and the hospitality shown. You're very welcome. To those who are shut in, our continual prayers with you. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and to serve the Lord. Thanks be to God. Thank you, everyone.